Yo, it's one pussy not registered pussy in my out. Mind.
Like, yeah, you were like, he's just getting pussy. Like,
he's just trying to get
she's
pussy.
The hottest girl in school, dude. Yeah. Obviously, he's trying to fuck her.
Yeah, yeah. But she's got big ass titties. Just like, that's all I
was she hot?
Yeah, she was hot.
To this day.
Sometimes I still know.
What was her name? Amanda?
No.
Is that the one you hid from the mentalist?
Oh, my God.
Yeah, but I realized that's what I did, though. I was like, oh, shit.
Dude, he tried to hide a thought from the guy who reads brains.
And he got it.
And he still got it. And he still got it.
Didn't that freak you the fuck out? That the one you almost thought of, he knew?
It did.
How far away was he? Did you give him credit for Amanda, or did he actually get it?
I don't want to fully expose everything, but I feel him getting Amanda almost makes me think I saw through a trick.
Why?
Honest. All right, because the person.
Wait, this is off pod talk. You can't ruin this, guys.
No, I don't think we're gonna affect it.
If it needs to be off pod talk, you can always, I guess, take it out. But
no.
So when we're starting, he's like put the names into the phone. I put in the Brittany, and that was real. And I was like, first kiss, and I was like, I think that was my first kiss, but I couldn't remember. Like, I think I told y'all before, I didn't kiss bitches until her, because it was like, they've all sucked dick. You don't kiss women. Like, that was like my thing.
Sound logic.
So I was like, but the both names are going to be the same, because then he asked me for both. And
how old were you when you first kissed?
16. Jeez. I was like, I had like little pecs. I had like little pecs and like
close mouth for sure.
Yeah. But those, I couldn't remember who any of those would be. So like a real make out, I was 16.
That was such a complicated question for you.
16?
16. But like, I tell you, they all suck.
How gross was it when you first kissed?
How
gross was it when you first had to kiss someone who
I was past it. Like,
you gave it up.
I gave it up. I was dating this chick for like 6 months. And then, then I finally kissed her. We were fucking
this is
that
Brittany.
Whole time.
What?
And I wasn't kissing her. And long, like LaMair said, it was at
they
the
started kissing.
Chick. Yeah, we started kissing. Then I found out she cheated on me with, like,
well, she was more, a gangbang chick?
You started
she
kissing got, like, at a gangbang?
Because LaMair said, y'all might not have heard it.
Somebody's doggy style. You're up front, like, getting your head rocked.
I'm so nervous for my first kiss.
Yeah, like, then she's a gang. What? She's literally got a trade ran on her.
Oh, no.
She was like, I should have known. She was letting me fuck her and not kiss her. I should have known she was sitting there like, he's doing the right thing. Like, just knowing that I shouldn't have done it.
Yeah.
But
she agreed. She was like, yeah, you don't want to kiss him.
She just was like, she would try and be like, fine, you're not ready.
While she's getting doggied.
You listen to Kiss by a Rose.
The song
took her top half out to like a candlelight dinner.
You know, the signs of her
teaser
being
under the table. Oh no.
The signs of her being a hoe were there. Like, I had people who I was bumping into.
That's
like,
the biggest sign.
Well, that
guy
also,
behind her flower.
I saw a friend who worked at a sneaker store. He was like, I heard you're fucking with Brittany now. I was like, yeah. He was like, finally got some pussy. Like, he just knew. Right. Like, if we're talking, he was like, you're around Brittany, you got some pussy.
Yeah.
But in that moment, it didn't register right away. And this I don't know.
Yeah, I hear you.
That's all right. You were young.
I was young.
You were young, dumb, and she was full of
and
bumped on you.
So, but back to the mentors. How I think I got
it. How, yeah.
I'm putting her name, and I was like, that's going to fuck up this thing if it's the same name for both things. So then in the app, the same website that I was at, putting the thing in again to just look at the stuff, I put in the next name. I was like, all right, this one comes to mind next, I'll do that. And then I was like, nah, just be honest. And I just stuck with what the thing was. And so I don't know if it's something with the site or something that he got.
You think he has access to the website?
I don't know. It was just like a regular name.
He wasn't on his phone.
What website?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't. It was like
baby name database.
Baby name database.
So he was, No.
Yeah. Probably not. But
it's also got to be real tough for him. For real. I know I joke a lot about race, but black people names.
Yeah.
Like a T in it. That could be fucking anything.
Yeah.
He must have been so surprised that it was a regular spelled Brittany.
No, it had an A.
No, it was an A.
It was an A.
I thought it was E.
No, that's or what
A.
I thought.
I thought A was regular. A I thought A was regular.
If it was a baby name director, maybe you saw how far you kind of scanned down, maybe. But even that is like, that's
impossible. You typed it in and just went to the page. Oh. You had to type it in. Yeah,
impossible.
My name.
That's impossible.
Yeah. You've been mentalized, dude.
Yeah, that's truly.
Yeah, but I also, y'all didn't give me enough credit for hacking into the powers a little bit.
No, that was crazy.
What do you mean?
You got the first.
You got 69. The six was good.
The six was good. The six was.
Was it because you saw me go?
No. I said six because he was like something about his, and I was like, yours is 666, calling him the devil. But then you must have made a face when I said six,
and you noticed it,
and he noticed.
Oh, okay.
They hacked into his black or his Jewness.
Yeah, I hacked into my true Hebrew. Like, yeah, I did also learn today on that baby website that Nathan is a Hebrew name. So
really,
the facts are out there. We're proving points.
Obviously,
you got any documentary shows to watch?
Yeah, I've already seen it.
It's pretty good.
Until a certain part.
I am Spud excited watches, to see it.
Until there's a part where they say the Holocaust didn't happen.
Yeah, so. I mean.
But like, where's the proof? I mean, look, I'm just a guy with some hunches, okay?
What are some of your hunches, for real?
I don't know, dude. Where the fucking, why do they got a gift shop in Auschwitz if it was so terrible?
Well,
that's not a hunch. That's just a stupid thing.
You don't want to buy a gift from Auschwitz.
What are the gifts they do?
Auschwitz?
Property of?
You get tattoos?
Property of, dude. That's crazy. Everyone's XXS. All right, come on.
All right, we're out of that.
Actually, cool. I would like to see if Auschwitz has a
I survived like the Grand Canyon thing. It's probably just like
I was in Auschwitz and all I got was just dumb keychain.
I don't think the Auschwitz has a gift shop.
That's not real. So that's
attempts
a
in the past.
Another confident lament statement.
That is according to the failing New York Times.
I said a hunch.
It's a hunch. Attempts in the past to sell cheap trinkets near concentration camps, including Auschwitz, have been quickly shut down.
Oh. So they gave it a shot.
We do not have things like medals or pencils with Auschwitz printed on them. And we don't intend to.
All right, maybe it was maybe it was really terrible.
No, I think
that was brave of you though to come around and grow on that topic.
Sometimes you gotta grow.
You gotta learn. That's I mean, that was a tough thing that you carried with you for a while. That you believed Auschwitz had a gift shop.
Dude, they had some people were selling. You know, they got rid of those guys.
Chicken on a stick, something. Snacks. You might be hungry, dude. You walked around. I had chicken on the stick the other day at a carnival. It was awesome.
Well, chicken on a stick.
Chicken on a stick.
It's great.
It was fucking so good. Chicken on a stick.
Chicken on a stick. I like a big turkey leg at an amusement park.
Ooh.
You like a turkey leg?
Giant turkey legs. Those are fun. When I was a boy,
that'd be crazy. You want to run
Auschwitz with a giant turkey leg? Bring so much food to Auschwitz. Gain weight at Auschwitz.
Just angry Jewish ghost.
You sat there and just pigged out. Everybody,
they would ask you to leave.
Somebody would ask you.
You brought like five sandwiches in and just kept eating.
Just a pulled pork.
I sat a picnic and laid down a blanket. You're like, what?
I'm enjoying Auschwitz.
You got a Groupon. Sweet. Buy one, get one. Oh, man. Yep.
All right.
I think we did it.
105. That sounds like, I think that's a good time to sign off. Once we start hitting the Auschwitz.
Yeah, that's usually.
Can you display the do?
The what?
The haircut.
Oh, dude.
Woo!
Look at that.
I thought you mentalist me. I was going to say that Auschwitz is the bottom of the 2 liter on a comedy podcast. That's
that's what you're done. That's just dog shit. That looks fucking good.
Nobody
dude.
Really cares. Yeah, it almost looks kind of ridiculous. I might.
No, it looks really cool. I said you looked Australian. You look Australian.
It looks too
cool.
I thought it'd be funnier.
No, it looks good.
It's funny. Thank you. The mullet's not bad.
It's a good mullet.
I want it to grow in a little more, though.
It looks cool.
Yeah, dude.
All right.
My hairdresser, wait. Helen, dude. Shout out to Helen.
You guys, come on. Panties in the Mouth podcast. Get on.
Oh, yeah.
Panties in the Mouth podcast.
Get all
subscribe
over,
to our Patreon.
There's another guy we never have had him on.
Andy.
Andy's been on.
Yeah, you weren't here. Andy has been on.
Yeah. He was on a live pod, too.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
That's when I hit him with the final word. I went, Andy, final word.
Andy, I would have had you on this one, but I wanted to only get black comedians. And then I didn't call any other black comedians.
Scare them with the mental
Yeah, I wanted to scare them with magic.
It's just like a group of black comedians.
That's what I wanted. I wanted several black comedians back here screaming. But then I felt like that was actually probably fucked up.
It would have been hilarious. I was on the edge of screaming. I was pretty close.
Because I was going to get
you
Godfrey.
Blocking me, I'd have left.
That'd be really funny.
I was going to get Godfrey. Yeah. I was going to get Godfrey, Reggie, and Aunt Moore, and have you five back there. And I realized that would probably be kind of disrespectful to Godfrey. Not that I haven't been that in the past, but we've moved past that, and I apologize. Sure. And so did he.
Yeah. For sure.
Grown men grow.
Yeah.
Heard that, bro.
Yeah. Sorry, Sean.
Yeah, just freeze frame it there at the end of it.
Yeah. All right. Thank you. Lucky with how I was there.
But it is fun. I went there a long time ago when I was like a very young man.
That might be aggressive.
Bro, I went out there with like literally zero money.
Yeah.
My cousin flew, like paid for my plane ticket. I went out there with a credit card and I did have a blast, but I remember being like, that's too much fun.
Yes.
I had to get home. I was like, I don't know how someone could do a week out there. I'd die.
No, I went and saw one of the nights I went off and saw Bargatze was there.
Nice.
Went and watched his new hour. So good.
Nice.
Nate Bargatze might be.
He's funny.
He might be number one.
Well, that was a dude I heard about forever and I never watched his clips. And we saw him in the tour bus. I was like, I got to see what this guy's all about. Dude, I was like, hilarious.
He's unreal. And then,
you didn't see Tony Dion?
St. Rogie's, you just go out and eat steaks every night.
Tomahawk?
Yeah, just huge, massive amounts of steak.
Oh, fuck.
It's pretty sick.
Is he full? Is he carnivore diet or is he keto, man?
He switches on and off.
Does he?
Let's talk Rogie's diet.
I'll talk Rogie's diet. I want to know. I just want to do whatever he does because I feel like he's got the inside.
Whenever I hang out with those guys, it makes me want to do what they do. Like, just eat steak.
Yeah, I feel like he's got the inside dope.
Then they work out. I would just be eating steak and just laying back down.
It's an oil tycoon. You'd be an oil tycoon.
Just steak and milk and just lay down.
True. But yeah, dude, that was pretty much it. I had that sexual experience. What else happened in Vegas? Or did it stay in Vegas?
I mean, obviously it stays in Vegas. What happens there does stay there.
True.
I don't know. I tried to gamble. My bank wouldn't allow me. I was like, I want to put $10,000 on Nate, which it would have. It was going to hit.
What
I knew
fuck?
It was going to hit. I only put like $400. Real fucking bummer.
Still won.
I know. I was like, I'm in Vegas. Let's go crazy.
What'd you do with the gambling winnings?
It's just on a card.
Oh, that stinks.
Yeah, but I'm going back for Skankfest.
Oh.
Yeah.
You're going to lose $10,000
on red.
That'll
be a tough one. No, I don't have $10,000. It was $800. I have a card. Then I'm going to go into the sports book and put it on. Then Notre Dame lost to fucking Marshall.
Marshall?
Marshall, dude. The Thundering Herd came in to set. Notre Dame sucks.
What the fuck?
Notre Dame fucking sucks, dude.
How the hell they lose to Marshall?
I don't know.
Get that news while in Vegas?
Yeah, I was watching the game in Vegas.
What's the half-life for you of like a Notre Dame loss, like biologically?
Thankfully, there was the Nate Diaz fight that
true,
night.
True, true.
So I was like, all right.
You took it, you went...
I didn't even have time to process it. I had to go straight to the fight. But during the fight, a lot of people were like, Marshall. They were just yapping at me.
That's
really, like, guys,
that's
come on. It's supposed to be a fun time.
It's kind of a microaggression, honestly.
For sure.
It's pretty fucked up.
So now Notre Dame plays Cal this weekend, tomorrow.
How you feeling about it?
Not great. They kind of stink. I think they're going to win. I'm back, dude.
And
they might win out.
I mean, coming off a loss like Marshall, dude, that's...
They better be hungry. They're wearing green jerseys this weekend. Are you excited?
Yeah, dude.
What's going on with the royal family? Any news?
Are you talking about Charlie Boy?
Yeah, what happened there?
Yeah. He can call himself whatever he wants. He's a king. Fat Finger King.
What happened with the Fat Finger King and the pedophilia?
Oh, he's a pedophile. Him and Lord Mountbatten were pedophiles. They got Jimmy Savile in there. The Queen protected him.
Yeah, but the guy,
the queen covered up the Epstein story originally.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that who got it sealed?
Well, when the media, they could have broke it, and the chick got hot mics. Project Veritas hot mic'd that one chick.
So she spilled the beans.
Yeah, she was like the royal family leaned on her, told her to shut it down.
Well, yeah, Prince,
they threaten your lives, dude.
Prince Andrew.
They're insane. Yeah, Prince Andrew's in the number two now.
Does it actually affect anything that the queen died? Because I've heard a lot of people being like, oh, man, this is the worst time for her to die right now.
It's, I don't
like,
know. It's
oh,
just
really?
So
she
weird.
She doesn't do anything.
I thought she was like a Chuck E. Cheese.
It
robot.
Is. It's absolutely a Chuck E. Cheese.
Dude, there's
robot.
People
she disappeared
being like,
a
this
bunch
is
of
not
kids.
A good time for her to die. Mm-hmm. Huh?
She disappeared a bunch of kids in Canada once.
True.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
What happened?
Just a bunch of, I think they were Indian kids.
Really?
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah.
They were under her dominion.
Yes. Yeah, Canada's theirs.
Oh, yeah, dude, so is Australia.
Oh, yeah, it's the Commonwealth.
Yeah, it's fucked up. So, yeah, so you were saying the pedo prince, Andrew, he can come back into the fold now?
Well, if Charlie Boy goes down and he needs somebody to, like, be his number two, Prince Andrew's back on the table.
I mean, hear me out. I mean, I think pedophilia is gross and wrong, but I feel like, what would you say? I'm going to play
stop you there.
Devil's advocate. Play devil's advocate. What do you say about like only monarchs can do pedophilia?
It does seem like it does come with the territory.
Yeah, I think they've been doing it for like 1,000 years.
Yeah, I think so. Nah.
pretty sure that's what the king's been up to.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Yeah. I think that's all you do as a king. You like someone tells you like, dude, I have any money? They're like, yeah, we have a lot of money. Like, nice. What's up with the kids? Like,
he's
yeah,
all like, dude. He's also
like,
a psycho.
You can't pay taxes. All right, bring me your child.
True.
He's also a psycho with the climate change stuff.
Who? Prince Andrew?
No. Charlie Boy. He was like the original Greta Thunberg.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, how about the Patagonia guy? Do you see that?
No.
Have you seen this? Have you heard about this?
Who's Patagonia guy?
The guy who owns Patagonia like sold all his shares to fight climate change.
What?
I think it was like $3.5 billion. Yeah. Actually kind of sweet.
It's kind of nice
if
of
you
him.
Believe that stuff.
it's nice of him to do.
Climate, so you think climate change is sweet?
What? I like the fact that the planet's
going up. Do you deny climate
up?
Change?
Dude, I have no idea. I can't. I'll be honest. If someone asks me like how the world's doing as a whole, I'm going to have to hit them with, I don't know how that works.
Yeah, I don't have a fucking idea.
I have no
dude.
Fucking idea.
I don't know how they predict weather.
Well, I hear people go like, well, the world warms up every now and again. I believe that. And people are like, bro, it's not. I've never been this warm. And I'm like, yeah, I only have maybe 4 years of actually paying attention to the weather under my belt. Collectively, so I'm
yeah,
like, I don't fucking know.
I forget every year.
I feel like
I literally forget what winter and summer are like.
Winters are warmer
annually.
I remember winters. I remember getting way more icy blasts as like the blizzard of 90. Don't get me started on the blizzard of 93.
How nice was that blizzard?
Bro, the blizzard of 93 was probably my favorite blizzard
That's
by far.
So sweet,
dude. Ice blizzard, dude. I remember walking up a hill. Actually, I fell and hit my head really hard. But the but yeah, I don't know. People ask that.
It was
go,
a
bro,
drift against our house that was like as tall as our fucking second story.
Fuck, dude.
It was so exciting.
Fuck
yeah, I was very excited as a young man.
Yeah, the blizzard, and I remember walking alone through it being like, does it get any better than this?
No, once you stop going to school though, snow fucking sucks.
Yeah, it's, it becomes
actually the first, while it's snowing it is sweet.
Yeah,
a little snow day,
you lock yourself in, it's kind of nice. But then
now I use that as an excuse. I'm like, all right, can't do anything, let's start drinking.
I fucked
then
up.
You black out and 6 p.m. and you wake up, it's can't leave
like
the house.
Weird, slushy,
you
shitty world.
In a scream
world.
Fight with your girlfriend in a blizzard.
Yeah, I fucked up. I got my first snowstorm last year with Maya, and I like brought her out to a full sledding experience, not knowing that like 1.5-year-olds get cold quick. And dude, I kept her out.
I've never known that.
I didn't know that. Brittany's like, I'm like, dude, they'll be fine. If I'm fine, she's fine. We, like, dude, we had like baby, like bullshit winter gear. So like we were out sledding, and she came back in. Like, dude, her like palms are like, she was red. She hit the bathtub and she was so cold the hot water hurt her.
Oh,
she was
God.
Yeah, I fucked up. That was my bad. I fucked up. I'll tell you, I own that. So I'm still working on that. People are like, what's your take on climate change? I'm like, bro, I don't know.
I'm figuring out babies.
I'm working babies' body temperatures, dude. I can't go for the planet. The
who would have known?
But yeah, I mean, could people use that for a nasty agenda? Maybe. I don't know. Who knows? But it's like, I don't fucking know, dude. All I know is I'm trying to get fucking ripped right now and take all my supplements, dude.
Yeah. We keep getting sponsors sending us supplements.
Dude.
It's pretty fun.
I'm whacked out right now. I told you, I had a fucking panic attack, dude.
Oh, yeah. Tell me about it. You hit the wall, dude.
I hit the wall.
Yeah.
You thought it was just me. That you can't combine the micros and the weed.
Bro, I did it one time at a dance, and I had to fucking run off the dance floor. Mid-dance floor, I froze. I was like, ugh. I get like this. It was like a wave. It's just like a... You know how they say like smoking DMT is like all of a sudden you're tripping in 2 seconds?
Yeah.
That's what my shit was. I get like, it's like a pulse of you're instantly in a panic attack in 4 seconds. And it just goes whomp and comes over you in one moment, dude. And I got hit with those. Literally, we're talking. I'm like, all right, I'm feeling kind of weird. I'm taking all these. I'm going to just munch and supplements. And you're supposed to, these certain kind, they're like, you can stack them with microdosing. I haven't microdosed in forever. I'm like, I'll throw that back in the ring. Munching a microdose, munching the subs, and I have a fucking keg of weed juice in my office, so I'm fucking like pounding that stuff.
God damn,
just chugging that because I kept being like, maybe I transcended my anxiety. I was like, I might be over it. Maybe I fucking move past it.
Maybe I no longer fear things.
Maybe I might be in a post. Like I'm talking about for my body, I'd get these crazy body. Oh, but still, I think I have figured out weed anxiety where I'm like, okay, this is this.
And dudes can champ it.
I've been champ.
I believe you can champ weed anxiety.
I'm sure if I start up in the ante on it, it'll get me again. But when you mix like a little bit of mushrooms and weed, dude, it gives you like for me, it's a different body feeling. So we're sitting there, we're chatting, we're talking. I'm like bullshitting about like being at a Coldplay concert in 2021. And he fucking, yeah. So I'm like, everything's good. Everything's fine. So we go to start and like, all right, let's start for real, dude. And I literally go to start and I just go, oh, like Sid asked me a question. I just went, should we pause for a second? And just had to go.
Holy shit.
I had to
shit.
Lean over, dude. I was fucking having a complete panic attack.
Nice.
And it's like.
Well, what was it about? Do you recall?
It was just physical sensations. Just everything. It was just physical sensation. I got I know the physical sensation of being high from weed, and I can champ that. The physical sensation of like, because it's like you get a physical sensation from weed, and you go, "Oh man, what if this gets worse?" That's where it all comes from. This might just be the beginning.
That's how I was.
But
at that fucking concert, I took a lot of mushrooms.
Did you?
I ate a good amount.
Really?
And like when it was starting to peak, I was like, ooh, I hope this stops.
That's what I'm saying.
I really hope this stops because I'm fucking like.
So.
And it did stop and I had a wonderful, wonderful experience.
See that? And that, and it always does. That's thank God.
And then it went back down. I was like, I need to keep eating more mushrooms.
You need to keep it going. I had the problem with me is the mushies alone, fine. The weed alone, fine. When I combine those two, dude, it spins every single time.
I'm sure.
I get this body wave from mushrooms and I'm like, in my head, I'm like, this might go super far.
Yeah.
And then I'm like, and then it's like lights, camera. And I was like giving a hot take on race. We were starting out with a hot take on race. And I was
on
like,
race?
He was like, what was that thing you were saying about like uncomfortable bringing minorities into like households in the 90s? And I was like, I've hit the wall. Complete bad. And then it just came up and, you know.
Yeah. I've hit the alcohol wall on several podcasts.
Did you?
And it's the worst feeling in the world, dude. I had a dude at the airport yesterday. He was like, saw you on the Barstool case race, dude. What's up? I was like, don't ever bring that up.
Dude, I hit the fucking wall.
I hit the wall so hard.
You were
that.
Nice watch. Oh, yeah. It was pure nice watch.
That was, I was on the wall there.
Yeah. And alcohol is a weird, that's a crazy wall.
I hit the wall on Kill Tony again.
Did you?
They keep doing Kill Tony after Rogan.
Yeah.
So we drink a lot on Rogan and then go to Kill Tony. And I'm obliterated. And anytime I'm hammered on a podcast, I just scream the whole fucking time.
I mean,
he's gay. Which I think is fun. I think it's fun.
Well, it's funny to be a critic of
I
that.
Have a fun time.
It is funny to be a critic
to
of that.
To be a Redditor?
Like, I didn't like a Redditor. Redditor.
A commentator.
Who coined? Was that your coinage?
Yeah, me and Billy.
Oh, Redditor.
The Redditors?
Yeah, the Redditors.
Yeah, but
the
it's
intelligentsia,
like,
that is Reddit.
That is the true intelligentsia.
Yeah. Oh, Reddit tour. But it's also to be like, that guy got too drunk on that podcast. There's some dudes that are too drunk for comedy shows. That show up to comedy shows like, yeah, I'm fucking sorry, man. I'm fucking
doing
the
man.
Show.
Oh, man. Getting hammered on it, going on and doing stand-up.
Yeah, fucking ruined the show.
Yeah.
Being hammered and doing, I mean, Kill Tony seems like a show that could handle being pretty drunk for that.
Yeah.
There's like 7-6 dudes on there. Seems like you got to chill
on
the
wings. No, that's the problem. You have too many cold ones. Now you're front and center. Dude. you're not going to chill on the wings. You're going to scream the entire time.
No, hold on. Everybody shut up.
Kenny was cutting in the whole show. Dude, I watched all of season 4 this past week.
Yeah.
I forgot how much I stole his personality. So he's like, the way you're talking to me right now, nasty. It's disgusting. Like all that shit.
I forgot about
it. I was watching. I was like, fuck, dude. Yeah, he's.
Just tell everyone, mate, season 4 sucks, dude.
Never watch it.
That sucks.
Don't watch season 4.
That show is actually
season
really
four
overrated.
So fucking good.
Dude, it was, I think, the best.
I think it's up there. For
I
sure.
thought the Mexico was the worst, and then I rewatched the Mexico, and I said that I was the funniest. One. Exactly, but it was the worst out of all of them. All of them were sublime perfection.
And then I was maybe like, South Carolina might. I don't.
Bro, walking in on his girlfriend getting his pussy eaten in the studio.
Yeah, in Mexico.
That was fucking funny.
I thought you were like a whore with a heart of gold or something like that.
You're just a whore. The whore's heart.
Yeah.
Unbelievable, bro.
I think that's far and away the best comedy.
I honestly think they fully. That's it. That's the gold standard.
Stevie? It's unbelievable, bro. I was watching the show. I was like, this is fucking crazy. This is the best show of all time.
It's literally the gold standard. It came
so good.
It came and everyone went, okay, it's as funny as a thing can get. From literally start to finish, there's not a single moment where I'm like, yeah, I wouldn't have done that. I'm like, that's the funniest.
It's
crazy. Oh yeah, that's the funniest.
The shit they say that it's just like he says racist shit like throughout
the very beginning.
Like, damn,
yeah,
just get away with it. It's fun stuff.
It is fun.
But yes, Denver was sick. Colorado was sick.
Yeah.
Red Rocks was pretty cool. Mushrooms.
It sucks when you do super cool stuff. As I understand, you have slight trepidation to talk about.
Yeah. It's like, I took a private jet and sat front row at the UFC fight.
That's not funny.
Yeah. The Redditors will be like, he's changed. Yeah, maybe I have, pussies. But no,
it is the whole point of life to change and develop.
So we did Red Rocks the night before.
Yeah.
Somebody hit me. Whoa.
We just have podcast gadgets.
Whoa, dude. You're going to hit the wall.
Who, me?
You're going to slam it.
As long as I don't have the microdose.
Little Dale Earnhardt, dude.
I'm going 2.3 volts. This is liquid live resin, so I want to keep the volts a little lower.
Okay.
If that's okay with you.
If I were you,
I mean, I don't know. You might want me to blast at 4 volts, but this is liquid live resin, so I should probably blast at on liquid live resin.
Yeah,
I might burn the card.
Okay, don't burn it.
I'll go up to 3.5 for you. See what's up. Yeah, bro. Taking myself back down to 2.
Hold on. So we did the Red Rock show, and
just kidding.
Those are your toys. Get your toys. You got toys, bro. What's this middle one? That's a toy.
This one?
Yeah.
This is the tombstone. That's a double.
I'm not fucking hitting that.
Take a single. That's a cloak.
I got cold sore.
Sorry, but guys,
that's a good way to get out of drugs. Sorry, I actually have herpes.
True.
Dang. I don't know if we have those.
Maybe we have before, but I don't know if we do.
All right. Well, do an endorsement for them. Ready, go. Here's some shit Matt left us.
I'll tell you what, this pot is great.
Good pot. From, what's the name of that company?
Hamilton Devices.
Hamilton Devices. Show them all the toys.
This is one of my favorite toys so far. It's almost like a switchblade.
Pops up, pops out. Feel like James Bond.
Feel like a sick ass guy. Sick ass weed head.
Speak up, dude. I can't.
That's how he seemed pretty sad.
Yes, that's a bad thing right now, dude.
So I owe that because I was quick to bring up the story as if that guy did do monkey gestures.
Well, I believe. Remembering from last week, I didn't. It didn't seem to me as if you were fully attacking the man.
I don't like to condemn people.
You just brought up the story, but no, you didn't. You didn't fully like attack the man.
In PK Subban's brother's defense, he was also in a hockey league in South Carolina, so you know his guard was probably up. Sounds That's like true. The whitest thing on earth.
That's true.
You know?
That's, yeah. No, I would be, maybe have your radar up a little, your antenna popped up a little bit.
Yeah.
Especially on the ice like that. Amongst the
blades. And on the ice, amongst the, when the whites are on the ice flying around.
Dude.
All of a sudden, speed's not a factor. Now, the white boys get a little arrogant, dude.
You just make us like we're balancing ourselves on metal blades.
Yes.
It's the equalizer for sure.
It is the equalizer. The great equalizer.
It is
the ice.
I don't know. They're all just like, I don't know. I'm just comfortable. I'm super comfortable. I don't know what it is about this setting. I'm just super comfortable.
Fly out here.
It's freezing fucking cold.
It's cold. It sucks out here.
All that Neanderthal DNA kicks in, dude. Yeah, for sure.
So Matt, you've been reading a lot about history.
A little bit. I read for
I'd
about
like to hear about it.
2 hours yesterday. It's a good book, dude. Well, so far, we'll see. I'm not sure. I haven't finished it, and I'm sure there's pushback. It's an ambitious book. The guy did a book, I think George Friedman. It's called The Next 100 Years. He wrote it in 2009. And he tried to lay out what will where will be in terms of geopolitics.
Yeah.
His to define it, he's saying geopolitics are the kind of like the churning and like invisible forces that come about from a bunch of distinct countries pursuing their rational end of like, if you're from Yugoslavia, you're going to want Yugoslavia to be doing as good as Yugoslavia like possibly can do. And that'll have an effect on the neighboring country, which then a bigger power might have to intervene. So he's saying that's geopolitics. There's just these things pushing at each other, and then things kind of pop up and happen. So he was saying his prediction is where we'll be in 2100. And the best part about it is he just comes right off the bat and he goes, it's going to look like I'm America centric, but all of this shit about America, like being over, he's like, it's just hogwash. He's like, we're a young democracy.
I agree with that.
We're a young democracy. We have just unrivaled military and economic power. He's like, it's not even fucking close. Like, he's like, it's not like our Navy, just our naval power. It's ridiculous.
I've chatted naval power on here.
I know.
We have 11 aircraft carriers.
Dude.
Most countries have fucking zero.
It's crazy.
Zero.
Did you get into
the next like top 10 combined don't equal how many we have.
Yeah.
It's crazy. Just, but there's one downside of that. That shit can get outdated. Your military can be obsolete in 10 years. It's happened before in history.
Really?
Yeah. Techniques and the technology your military uses. Like, I think it was World War One. Mm-hmm. Italy had a nice little fleet. And then aircraft came around and just fucking bombed the fuck out of their fleet while it was in, you know?
Yeah, it's true.
And they're like, fuck, we wasted all of our time and money on that.
Yeah, and you don't have any more left.
Now we wear the boats. No, they were just here.
Whose side were they on in World War One?
World War One, they were.
They didn't join the Axis. That was World. That was
no
WW2.
World War Two was Axis. They joined. Then they flipped.
I know.
World War Two, they're like
very Italian.
You're not doing great. We switch side.
Hey, what's going on?
World War One, the Italians were fighting the Austrians.
Yeah, I think so.
So I think they were on the Allies.
Are you with the conspiracy theory? Well, it was back then. It was a conspiracy theory by one of like the German leaders saying like that was all orchestrated to knock Germany down.
Yeah.
Like England conspired because England wanted to fuck them up.
Yeah, that's some Hitler talk.
Is that Hitler talk?
Yeah.
Okay. I heard
that's good Hitler talk.
That's Hitler talk.
No, it was World War One started with Serbia.
Yeah.
They shot Franz Ferdinand.
Yep.
Yeah.
Well, dude, the book talks. So basically, the book's saying
Russia jumped in and Russia and Germany jumped in. They're like, don't fuck with us.
Yeah. So the book was basically saying, like, dude, all this talk about America, like, America's a young country that's like leaving pretty recently in terms of like historical, like, span of like, you know, civilizations or whatever. It's just leaving a barbaric phase. Like, we're just getting out of barbarism. And it's like, you know, relatively in terms of like how our very beginnings, because we got to start a little later on.
I don't like when they talk in phases like that.
Yeah.
Like, because they were doing that with Islam for a while. They were like, well, when Christianity was this old, we were doing the Inquisition. And it's like, yeah, but that we didn't do the Inquisition in 2020.
Yeah, yeah.
But
he's saying he's
just
like,
a weird.
He was like, yeah, true. But he's saying we're like going. He's like, Europe ruled. What was that? What did they have their thing for like 300-400 years? That's when like they had like their dominion over like.
Yeah.
The greater part of the world.
Yeah.
So they were all running around doing all this crazy stuff where like they were just conquering. But then they would fight each other in the meantime. They'd have all their little things and like England would be like, what's up, France? Bah! France like, fuck you, dude. They basically tore each other to shreds. They just tore themselves to shreds. And I think the one thing they're saying is America in the First World War. No, I think it was the second. They stepped in to help. England was fucked in the Second World War. America was like, we'll help you. And they did this thing. It was this weird naval deal. Like, we'll lend you boats, but you got to give us all of your naval bases, like in, like it kind of close to us. So America apparently like assumed a ton of like English or British naval bases.
Yeah, they say that World War II was actually, it might have been World War I, was like when the banks shifted from London to America.
Yeah, yeah.
Like it all shifted to America. We took everybody's loans.
Yeah.
We paid for the war. We profited off the war. We were late to both wars. Mm-hmm. We didn't join either of them.
Yeah.
Until late.
America was 500,000 dead, and I think World War II had 10 million casualties.
Yeah.
Was not bad.
Yeah.
I mean, that's 500,000 bros. They were saying like a whole, almost.
There was way more than 10 million casualties.
Yeah, yeah, true.
Like,
yeah.
Russia had 20.
Yeah. See, and they were saying like, there was like almost
England
like.
Had like 4 mil.
Well, they were saying that, like, almost there were countries where, like, almost an entire generation of men got wiped out. Yeah, they were like an entire generation of dudes just gone.
There's a year in France that there's no men that year from World War One. Yeah,
dude. Well, basically, so the book is basically saying, like, going off of, like, the European, like, for how long Europe was in power, they had, like, a long time. They got to kind of, like, they eventually, you know, they basically put us, like, just destroyed each other. But he was like, America's only been in power for so long, and we also have this unprecedented, like, economic power, control of both the Pacific and the, you know, Atlantic Ocean, which is big. And they're basically saying, like, dude, we'll be ruling up until 2100, and they think that the biggest, the person who will come to power that nobody is actually, like, predicting, Mexico. They're saying in the year 2100, Mexico is going to try to claim Texas back and parts of California, like the part we took from Mexico.
Yeah, right.
Dude, well, this is why they're saying that, because they're saying we're going to have, the population is going to drop, and then we're going to have to start enticing immigrants. It'll be the opposite, where we're trying to keep people out. We're going to be competing to entice immigrants to come to the country. And then, like, that's going to, like, boost their economy and all this.
Does he
talk
about how China's population is actually dropping?
He basically says China's just going to...
China's dropping, and they're all old now.
Well, he was saying
China's in trouble.
They're going to revolt, and this is 2009. He was like, the coastal regions in China get really rich when they open up trade to the outside world, and then the people on, like, the inside of China just are poor as fuck, and then they eventually just revolt against the rich.
Yellow,
like,
turbans, bro.
China in 2009. He also called. He goes, this whole, like, jihadist war, nothing. He's like, that'll just go away.
Yeah,
he's right about that.
Yeah,
he's like, he called it a spasm. He's like, that was just a spasm.
Well, that was, I think that was a bit of a result of the West meddling, dude.
Well, dude, so he talks about the fact that after World War II,
they were just poor guys chilling.
Oh yeah,
well, fucked with.
So what he was saying is
not saying they're good guys.
Yeah, no, yeah, they're just.
I don't want to sound like a damn hippie right now.
No, they're just guys. You know,
they're dudes.
They got sucked. They got sucked into a thing.
Up to no good themselves.
They were trying to restore a world Muslim empire. That's what he talked about that a lot. Again, I'm only like a quarter of the way through.
He wants the Ottomans, dude.
He talked about how, like, those dudes would be like, yo, we used to run the world. Let's go.
The Ottoman Empire was big dogs.
Yeah, but, like, they didn't know what the fuck was going on. Then, like, meanwhile, America's
who?
Like the dudes over in the Middle East.
No, they were doing what they, it was oil got them. Once Europe was like, yo, Europe and America were like, what do you guys have? We need oil.
Yeah. Well, that's the other thing too. People are like, oh, America still is a major producer of oil. They still produce a ton of energy, just not as much as, like, the leading.
We might have to cut off the Ruskies. They keep acting up.
Oh, the Ruskies.
We're going to prohibit Europe from buying Russian oil.
He was saying...
they'll go to China.
He said Russia will collapse again as well. He's like,
Russia's already on its fucking...
But he said, like, they'll do, like, a fall of the Soviet Union.
Oh, okay.
Because the thing he was saying was once World War II happened...
It's good
happened,
we're predicting the future right now.
This guy did it.
With all my fucking... I rewatched the last episode of Adam Curtis this week. I know all about this stuff.
Exactly, dude. I've read this one book, and at least now... I was able to go, like, oh, I've, like, heard stuff like that. But what he was saying, after World War II, Europe was just in shambles. Russia was like, well, we'll be king of the shambles, and we'll run Europe, and we'll get, like, access to Europe's kind of, like, farm, all this other stuff. And America was like, we can't have that. So that was the Cold War. And then once the Soviet Union collapsed, the Soviet Union kept that, like, weird no man's land of Eastern Europe into the Middle East check. Yeah, kept them in check.
Yeah.
Because they, like, they wouldn't bust it. Because that was all dudes from, like, old civilizations who would be like, the Phoenicians will rise. Like, there were all these weird old civilizations. Like, we got to fucking rise again. But Russia would be like, not right now, guys, stop.
Yeah.
As soon as Russia fell, because we had been training Afghan, you know, that, like, the Afghani guys the whole time, Russia fell. And then they were like, oh shit, this is up for grabs now. So it's been a nonstop domino. People were like, oh shit, they collapsed, up for grabs.
Yeah.
Pretty tight.
Yeah.
And just the whole place, apparently, I didn't know that after the Cold War, that stretch of, like, the Balkans, just fucking erupt. It was, that was like Kosovo and all that shit when we were little.
Yes.
I didn't know about that. I mean, I heard about it, but that's where it came from.
Of course.
I didn't know this.
This is how history works.
I knew this is how it
goes. You can literally, it keeps going.
It's crazy.
You can blame, the way things are right now is from the American Civil War.
Dude, and that's.
Things that happened then.
Yeah.
Things that happened, and that happened because of the revolution, that happened because.
It's crazy.
Every single thing you can.
It's pretty tight.
The way things are now is because of the Haitian Revolution. That's how history works.
It was nuts.
It's wild.
Man. It was really nuts.
That's why I'm such a big fan of it. I say, wow, what a great subject.
Wow. But the funny
when I was a young boy in fifth grade, I said, wow, what a great subject.
That's interesting. the funny thing was he was saying America, the reason we get all doom and gloom all the time, he's like, that's just built into our, the way we are. Cause we're still like, we're still in a thing where it's like, we're paranoid as fuck. Cause we've done all these things out of this position of like a scared, young, insecure country of being like, fuck, fuck, fuck. We got to build a Navy. Fuck, 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 fuck. And we've just amassed this gigantic fucking superpower.
Somebody sent me a book. I got to check it out, dude. Yeah. It's a hero of both worlds. It's about Lafayette.
What?
You'd like this boy.
What's he do?
He was a baller in France. He came over and helped.
Oh, the guy who trained the American Revolution. Yeah.
And then he went back for the French Revolution.
Damn.
He's a G. I think, if I recall correctly, he was kind of against the French Revolution. He was like, yo, chill the fuck out.
Beast.
And the boys got wild anyway.
Yeah, they did. They did. Yeah, dude, jerks. That book was pumping me up big time, dude.
I got a big fight with my girl. You would like this.
About what?
She was just talking about how great France was. I was like, the French suck.
Yeah, dude.
You don't understand beauty and fucking architecture. And I was like, Ireland's better than fucking gay-ass France.
France had one good run. Napoleon pushed it. Napoleon had a nice
France
push.
Has been beasts throughout history. Joan of Arc was a beast. I mean, they were always the beast of Europe.
I never really...
Until the Deutschland came around, dude. Deutschland.
Yeah.
England and France were always the ones fighting. Because they were both trying to assert. I said Spain, dude. Spain's up there with France. Historical domination.
Yeah.
Spain rules.
Yeah, they were all doing their thing.
Now they're taking naps. They did it. They worked.
Dude,
they're done working. They retired. Spain retired. Greece retired first. Greece was like, we're done forever. We did it.
Yeah.
And she was talking, this made me laugh, but just how they've been in, like she went over there in 2016 and they still hadn't touched buildings that they were building in 2008 from the collapse. So there's just... There's more ruins.
Oh, that's what you're
Greece
talking about.
Greece is actively operating on ruins. They built more ruins in 2008. The entire country's ruins and stray dogs.
So they just abandoned like skyscrapers and
they abandoned every construction project that they were working on.
It's beautiful now.
Yeah.
This is where guys in hard hats used to eat lunch 4 years ago and they stopped.
Yeah, Greece loves ruins. Spain's up there. Spain rules. Yeah, they went hard and then they took a nap.
He's got to get real into food. But that was
an argument. French has good food? No.
French food stinks,
French food
dude.
Stinks. Thank you.
French food stinks.
It's fucking carrots and gravy and
bread.
Mushrooms.
Yeah, it's
and crap.
Bread. It's crap.
Crap.
They're good desserts, I'll give them. I think...
tiramisu is pretty good.
Isn't that Italian?
It's Italian?
Yeah, French de creme brulee, I think.
Look
creme brulee is French. They busted the torch out and figured
off.
Out. Huh?
Well, fuck them. I thought tiramisu was there.
No, that's Italian.
How about that? The croissant.
Yeah, that's... Lame as
croissant,
hell.
Yeah.
Throw those in the trash.
They're good, but they're not Oreos.
Yeah, dude. Throw those
they're
in
not
the trash.
American cookies.
High fructose corn syrup?
Yeah.
Pretty delicious.
America is the best food.
Yeah, it's like 21,000
We have American
calories.
Chinese food, American Italian food.
Amen.
We did it.
Oh, of course.
Yeah, we were in agreement America is the best, though.
No, that was good to hear, though. You get a lot of people dooming on that whole thing, like, oh, we're falling into it. And it's like, this guy was like, dude... It's like an adolescent phase America's going through. We're like, oh, like we'll go through periods of like, we're the fucking best. And be like, oh, fuck, we're fucking, everything's falling apart. He's like, you just go in and out. He's like, we're immature as a culture and we're going to reach maturity in the next 50 years. Because apparently he was saying you go through the barbaric phase, which is like basically the people of a country. You know, he's like, there's differences here and there. But by and large, it's people who are like, if you disagree with what I think fundamentally, you either need to completely change your views right now or be destroyed or silenced. It's like, that's barbaric. Once you're truly civilized, you're able to have your own views and be like, I believe in my views. I can hear like I can see what you're saying. Take little parts, things. You're not just like, shut the fuck up, right? That's barbaric. Yeah. And then he said after what happens is people go from civilization into the decadent phase where it's like nothing's even right at all. Who knows what's what?
You become a rich kid from Manhattan.
And that's Europe. He's like, that Europe's in a decadent. He's like, Europe fell into decadence. And it's just kind of like, who even knows? Why do you Americans even make such a big... He's like, that's bullshit. Barbarism's bullshit. We need to reach our civilized phase before we clash with the lads.
The lads.
He thinks Poland's going to become a next superpower. I think he said Poland. Turkey. He's got his...
He's saying Poland and Mexico. He's saying the rise of the Catholics.
Yes, and Turkey. He thinks Turkey's going
to
rise.
It's time for the Turks to convert.
He was basically saying a lot of the great Islamic stuff was... A lot of it came through Turkey. Or like had a Turkish print on it. So he was like, Turkey, Poland, U.S., Mexico. He's like, they will be the superpowers of the world.
I fuck with that.
Russia collapses. China collapses. Poland's going to be strong.
Poland's going to be tight.
He said Poland has been off the map for a while. He's like, they're going to come back. So they were great in like the 1300s, 1400s.
They were.
He said they're coming back.
They stopped the fucking, the Muslims.
Yeah, dude.
I think it was the Hungarians and Polacks.
They just did a big head shield, dude. They just fucking.
Yeah, they ran straight at them with their dumb heads. But then, you know, the Ruskies and Germans gave them what for?
Yeah, you know, that's tough.
Now the Germans are soft, dude. I think they might be lulling us into Germany. They might be lulling us, dude.
Nah, Germany's.
They're like, no, we're good guys.
True.
We forget about what we did.
True. We actually care about carbon emissions. We don't even, not even work.
Forget about that thing, babe. I love you, dude. I'll never cheat on you again. Come even on. Though I cheated on you twice.
Yeah. Germany's, I think Germany, that was the other thing they're saying about America. We're not that densely populated at all. And we have more farmable land per acre than almost any other country.
Definitely.
So it's
that's
like,
what fired me up. I remember that when the Japanese
we'll get it back
when the Japanese were going to war with America, they were like having war discussions. Should we attack Pearl Harbor? Should we start this war? And there were dudes, half of them had studied in America. Most of their officers had studied in America and they were like, don't do it.
Yeah.
This whole thing is, it's a field. They have all the food and industry in the world.
Yep.
Don't do this.
Yeah.
And they did it, dude. And they found out. They learned a very valuable lesson.
True.
The hard way.
He pumps Japan. Twice. He pumps Japan up big time. He's like, Japan
rules.
Japan will keep going.
I'm confused. Dude, I just came back from Chicago.
Oh, how was that?
It's miserable, bro.
Yeah.
It's miserable, dude.
That must have been tough because normally you're optimistic.
I am.
Normally, like when I call you and I'm like, how's it going? You're like, it's not that bad.
Yeah.
This was the first one where you're like, this thing.
It's tough,
and
dude.
I was like, oh, man.
And I still
it was.
I kept
by the way, cool. I know your weekend. I would have spazzed, dude. I would have cried. I would have frustrated cried.
I've been getting good at just letting things, just not trying to change the way things are. I can just accept a thing and I'm like, this
dude, definitely
I
had to walk
sucks.
Into Nashville and I spazzed.
Why?
In downtown because there are too many bachelorette parties. And I was like, where are we going? Where are we going? You tell me where we're going. You don't even know.
I had one spaz. I was complete. I was the sublime one, dude. All
you
week.
Were very subliminal.
I was chilling and like nothing. It was like, dude, it was this leading up to that from Wednesday or maybe Tuesday, we were getting no sleep. Because Maya's molars are coming in, so it was like, we're up.
I'm already done.
Dude, I flew into Chicago on like 3 days of not getting sleep already with this a kid just wiggling, trying to just not go to sleep on a plane, just being like.
So was she loud on the plane or were you good?
Oh, she was loud as hell, bro. Oh. She's screaming. But she eventually fell asleep. So dude, I could care less, dude. When the baby cries, I'm just like, I dare someone to say something.
Yeah, yeah, of course. No one's going to say anything. But man, when that baby sits behind you on a plane.
Genuinely doesn't bother me.
And fucking,
shut the fuck up.
No, just grab its head.
It never bothers. Whenever I hear babies cry, I can drown it out.
Yeah, I mean, usually I have cool songs playing. I'm usually listening to Drake on my way to Rochester.
You see her.
Yeah, it really kills the vibe of Drake.
Yeah, true. Drake seems like he would be
annoyed. No crying babies.
Yeah, Jake.
He would never be in coach.
Yeah, he doesn't like that energy, dude.
No.
Can you even bring a baby in first class? I think if your baby cries
in first class,
the toilet.
Yes, I'd be fumed.
They just kick it off the plane.
If I bought a first class ticket and had to sit next to a crying baby.
Yeah, dude.
I would cry.
I paid all my money for this ticket.
Dude, I'm on like an absolute just time vortex. I have not slept in 3 days. We fly out. To Chicago. Flight is, you know, it's just miserable flying with a kid. It sucks. So we're doing all that. And then we get there and we're in this hotel. And dude, I was in the hotel like years ago. And I swear it was awesome. We got there and it sucked. It was just shitty. We're in a shitty hotel.
Shitty hotels are
dude,
terrible.
It was like depressing. Dude, when you're in a shitty hotel, it's depressing. Like, you know, because I always walk into nice hotels and I'm like, do they really need all this quality shit? And you walk into one without one, you're like, this is like a shitty apartment.
Where's this gold chandelier?
Yeah. Like
what the fuck is this?
I'm just in like
an Indian guy that lives behind the desk.
Yeah, dude.
You ever run into those?
Yes.
they always live back there. It's a sick setup. I was always, it's funny, when I was younger, I was jealous of that job. You know how like people see trash men are like, I want to be that.
Yes.
And the parents have to be like, no, you don't.
Yeah.
Except in your house. That's been a nice dream of mine.
To just sleep.
work night shifts at a hotel and just live behind the desk, dude. That could be how I retire. If things don't go well, I'm doing that.
It probably rules, dude.
Get a cot.
You talk to hookers all night.
You sit at the front desk, you fucking check in. Breakfast is 9 to 6. Yeah. Whatever. And then you go back to your room.
Video games.
There's a bro
masturbating.
Who messages us on Patreon. He does. This is. He works. I don't think he has the cot, but he works at a hotel.
You need a cot.
He works at a hotel, and he's like, bro, I'm constantly seeing like hookers and like just fucked up shit going down. You see hookers like bring their kids in and shit.
Mm.
Yeah, he's like, it's fucking brutal.
You think bringing a kid on a plane?
You think a hotel's all fun and games? Bro. Yeah. Yeah, it's like I thought about that. I was like, so yeah, we're there. It's just just shitty. But we at one point it's just me and Mike. Brittany was in the bridal party, so she's like just doing all the shit constantly. So we're just in a hotel trying to like order food from fucking Grubhub and shit. It was a nightmare, dude. It was a total fucking nightmare. So so at one point, you know, we're like sitting there. She wouldn't sleep.
I'd like to see you frustrated in the room. That'd be funny.
I just get a 1,000-yard stare. I just blank. As soon as I catch myself getting frustrated, I just check in and just go, you're frustrated right now, brother.
You just gotta let it go.
It's mindfulness. What are you talking about? It's mindfulness. I just let myself go.
Shitty hotel in Chicago. Like, don't let it get to you, brother.
Dude, literally.
Your inner monologue.
That's my inner monologue.
Oh, brother.
It'll be Sunday soon enough, yeah, brother.
True.
Dude, this was all the anticipation. It was a Sunday wedding, too. So, like, I was there Friday. I was at the rehearsal dinner, dude. Show up. And, you know, I'm the south side of Chicago. I'm the only white dude.
Yes.
You know? So I show up. I go to the back room. The first person I'm going to go in there goes, excuse me, sir, the bathroom's here. And I was like, excuse me?
I'm actually here. Yeah.
So I just sat there for like 2 hours and just like watched them rehearse the wedding.
Oh, my God.
And just chilled. I was just chilling.
You had to watch the rehearsal?
Yeah. Because, yeah.
Jesus Christ.
They're a little behind schedule, bro. No big deal. Started a little late, dude. I'm talking like it was insane.
Really?
Oh, my God.
So it's not just comedy shows that start late.
This was wild.
How late?
It was the dinner. It's supposed to be rehearsal than the dinner, and I showed up for the dinner, and lo and behold, it's like, oh, cool, the rehearsal.
Yeah.
It was
late. And you got to watch the rehearsal.
I watched the whole thing. Just sat there, and it was like, you know, it's like mask. What are people wearing masks? People not wearing them. A lot of people wearing a lot of black patriots out there not wearing them.
True.
Pumped on that. Dude, in Chicago, I thought they'd all be spellbound by their mayor. Dude, in the shitty hotel I was in,
yeah,
nobody was wearing them.
Yeah.
Nobody. They did look at you. It was just funny.
Yeah.
But yeah, dude, it was cool. The wedding itself was fucking, I took my mushroom microdose out, you know, it was wedding protocol.
Yes.
Showed up. Yeah.
Did you get a little, you have a drink or two?
No, I just had a couple glasses of wine. Nothing crazy.
Yeah.
Chilled there. And
how many glasses?
Just two. I chilled there.
You were feeling good though.
I was fucking
chilling.
Yeah. I was at like a table of like when they just throw mushrooms, a bunch of random people.
Glasses of wine.
Yeah, man. Yeah. Watching it was just speeches too, dude. So many speeches. I watched, there was like 3 bridal party speeches, a best man speech, a brother speech. The grandpop came out and started, I kept almost crying too. I don't know if it was the mushrooms. I was getting like really moved.
It's because you're ready, dude.
I was getting moved.
It's because your big day.
True.
This is going to be my day someday.
Dude, the grandfather.
You already had a day, you selfish pig.
I'm such a groomzilla, dude.
You are.
I'm such a groomzilla. Dude, everything better be perfect. I'm going to snap. Oh,
I hope you spaz and cry at your wedding.
No way, dude.
Everything's not perfect.
Yeah, I was sitting there.
Shane, you're drunk. You couldn't keep it together for one day.
I was watching, dude, the brides, the shit my wife had to do. And her cousin's like super nice. But it's just like the level of shit of like the descent with like there's a lot of people in the bridal party will like try to be like, well, I don't want to do that. And they all start fucking fighting.
Yeah, it's ladies.
It's crazy, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're so bad at hanging out.
Well, that's because they always make other people do things.
True.
Ladies are constantly like, we're doing this.
Yeah, man.
I'd never do that to people.
It's crazy.
I'd never do that to people.
Dude, it's insane.
Well, I did just buy a beach house and make everyone go to Florida. But
no, that's fun.
I didn't care if no one
went. Imagine if you were like, guys, and like just for one night, can we all just coordinate outfits?
Yeah.
And you take a picture and someone's like, can I wear this? You're like, no.
God, she's such a bitch all the time.
Dude, it's wild, bro.
Yes.
It's wild.
We should start coordinating more outfits.
I mean, I'm just going to, you can coordinate this. All I'm wearing in Florida is a bathing suit. I'm going to bring 4 bathing suits.
Are you excited for a beach trip?
Oh, I can't fucking wait, dude.
Damn.
I can't.
Gardini, sorry, man. Big kids only. You're the little
back
kids.
On big kids. Yo, if you strap them fangs, you, dude.
You don't have to carry any drugs, but
I'll do that.
If you want to come, you can. Yeah, you're going to see some drugs. It was funny. Spud was like, I'm bringing mushrooms. I was like,
easy.
Don't do that. And he was like, Man Tom said it was cool. I was like, don't listen to Man Tom.
Capsule format, dude. It's a supplement. It's you're going to get a bottle. I have.
Yeah. I do. Yeah, true. This weekend.
It's my medicine, dude. Yes. What are they going to do? They're going to force me to take a fucking experimental vaccine. Well, now almost one of them.
FDA approved.
Although, looking to the FDA, they've done a lot of bad things. But the
no, I love the FDA.
FDA?
I love them.
Nah. They're, I mean, it's good. They're there.
What do you think I love more than food and drugs? Of course I love the association or whatever
the
fuck they are.
I think they're doing their best job. It's just, you know, let me fly with mushrooms.
They will let you fly with mushrooms.
They do. They don't care. They don't care about the weed pens. They genuinely don't give a fuck.
Man, they'll fucking nail you for a bottle of water.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. You gotta wait fucking 25 minutes when they go through all your shit.
Yeah, man.
Because you forgot a bottle of water in your book bag.
We brought coconut milk with us. But here's the thing. If you have a baby, you can bring liquids and be like, that's for the baby.
Yes.
The one lady was just like, this is baby food. I'm like, come on, lady. Like, we give it to the fucking kid.
It's like, no, I eat it.
And I did drink it, though. Coconut milk is so delicious.
Really?
Oh, my God. They're coconut smoothies. It's just this little bottle. It's just coconut milk and coconut water. And
you eat the baby's foods?
I eat the baby's foods all the time.
Those are good foods.
Oh, yeah. Chocolate coconut milk?
So you go to this horrendous fucking garbage wedding.
I won't say that. Right? It was fun.
Yes.
It was at one point, too.
Was there cool dancing?
Dude, that was a thing. There was no dancing. I was all.
You went to a black wedding and they.
Oh, it was. So this is what happened. So it's like the speeches ran so long. It's a Sunday wedding.
They ran the light.
They ran the light. You should have. A lot of guest spots. There's a lot of guest spots going on.
They love guest spots.
A lot of guest spots. And at one point, this like grandfather comes out and he was just like, he's so old, dude. And he was like, I just can't put the feeling I have for this girl into words. I just love her. And I was just like. Start fucking about the dude. I was at a table with like mostly
baby.
Literally most exactly mostly gay dudes who were like, "Oh my god, wrap it up!" And I was
like, "Yeah,
like,
yeah."
The whole time,
beautiful speech. It was a beautiful speech.
The one dude actually this is a phenomenon I've seen at wedding where like the groomsmen have been putting on like they do like stand up sets now, dude. They go hard.
Get ready for yours, dude.
It's gonna be sick.
I'm working on a set.
Epic, dude. It's gonna be epic.
I'm just gonna do my hour.
You should. You should.
Dude, Trump? You guys remember Trump?
That was a good speaker, too. My brother, Tom.
I bet.
He's decent.
I'm terrible. I'm actually bad. I'm very bad at public
speaking. Gives me the willies.
Yeah.
I'm hoping Bert. Oh, by the way, Bert's out of jail.
Bert home.
Bert's out of jail. He wants to come back on.
Oh, nice.
He was locked up all during COVID. Yeah. He was in county jail. They stuck him in there. He couldn't get out because his trial got pushed back.
Oh no,
dude, his stories are they're so funny. Yes.
Why didn't we have him on?
He got out and he got this job now where he's just like nobody wants to work. So I've been getting the best jobs. So he's getting a job where they're flying him around the country to install LED lights, and he's getting like $55 an hour.
Oh no,
he's in like Mississippi right now, dude. No, it's good for him. It's good. He's out. He's moving around, dude. Bert, he might be the funniest dude in the world.
Nice.
Just like his like little revenge schemes he got on like people in jail, and dude, it's so funny.
Good. I look forward to that episode.
I don't want to spoil it. The one story was just tickling me, and I'm like, I'll wait till he comes. But yeah, he's like, yeah, man, fucking nobody wants to work. So I came out and I was a project manager. Right away, I'm a project manager. So he'd come back to his fucking recovery house and he'd come in and he'd keep his shirt tucked in. And he'd be like, hey guys, project manager's back. He started bossing around people. She's like, these old dudes like really fucking hated me, dude.
It's funny that like people aren't working.
Yeah.
And they're still not taking the vax. They're like just sitting home taking the government's checks. And the government's like, will you please get the vaccine? They're like, no. Keep sending us money.
Well, that's going to change.
It's awesome.
They're going to be able to hook to
the government. Stop giving people money, dude.
Did they stop already?
No, they should. I just got my stimulus check.
Did you?
I just got it. $1,400. I got it this week.
Wait, what stimulus?
I don't know. I got a stimulus check for $1,400.
Yeah. It's crazy.
Yeah. I was like, I don't need this. I'm going to owe them money.
Yeah, they're going to take it back.
Yeah. So just keep it. Put it on my tab, dude.
They're baiting you.
They're going to get me.
Yeah, they
will. The IRS is going to be in my ass, dude.
They're, yeah.
Pause.
Yeah, true. Yeah, the wedding was good. The wedding was all good. We ducked out of this. This is what I meant to tell you. So you're asking about dancing. I'm primed up. I'm ready to roll, dude. You know, I'm fucking I'm an underdog story, getting ready to go out there and do my stuff. Just the groomsmen went out and danced. It was all the dudes. Just dudes. The opposite, dude. It's fucking. I was like, what the hell? Just dudes. And it's like they're singing that, you know, the Outkast song, like,
yes.
I Choose You.
Yes.
They all come out, and it's like, I watch this as like, you just sit there and rap along with your boys and just kind of like, dude.
I just did that. That was one of the hit songs at the karaoke. Remember, I went to the African American karaoke party.
Yeah, and you sang your choice. Was
choose
poor.
You was that was my choice was poor. Thought it was gonna be a fun gag. Skinner with the fucking.
You didn't think they're gonna put the fucking stars and bars behind you.
Not good.
So wait, they did I Choose You?
Yeah,
dude. It's like maybe they're practicing for a wedding because these dudes came out and were polished, dude.
Yeah,
I was
they all know. Yeah.
I was like, I'm not, dude, they were like spaceships and they're like, dude, all the hands.
Whoa.
Shoot, sorry, my bad. But the,
pause.
My bad, pause, dude.
Dude, pause.
But yeah, they're doing like, they're like just fucking like rapping along and like they knew all the cool stuff to do, like the ad libs and stuff or whatever. And the pantomimes, I should say. And, I just was like kind of intimidated and I just sat there and I was like, can you guys have people speak?
True,
again?
It does suck when you don't know the words. Everyone else is rapping.
Well, I feel weird too, coming out and like
kind of knowing the lyrics. You say a couple and then you know when you fuck up a lyric, you just have to like keep talking.
Risky business too, because I'm rapping along with people and it's like I might just go on autopilot mode.
Yes.
And fucking ruin my career, dude. Fucking.
Oh man, that'd be a tough place to hit one.
I didn't know. I thought this was the edited version.
Yeah.
But yeah, dude, So yeah, I watched them do that. By then it was winding down, so I just I was like, we hit the bread. I'm like, let's fucking roll.
Nice.
So, yeah. Dodge that bullet. I just don't like any song that enough to go out with my boys and be like, whoa, let's sing this together. I just don't care for it like that, you know, and I'll be faking if I'm doing that. I can't.
You wouldn't want to jump around and sing a song with me?
With you, I would. You're my boy.
Hold one hand.
You're my boy. I would sing your song. I would sing like our favorite songs together.
What would you say your favorite song is?
Oh, man.
That we could sing together.
That you and I